The Falcon 9 rocket uses subcooled liquid oxygen and chilled RP-1 as propellants. But what makes these different from regular liquid oxygen and RP-1? Well, the biggest difference, as their names imply, is the temperature. The liquid oxygen on the Falcon 9 is cooled to negative 207 degrees centigrade, and the RP-1 is cooled to negative 7 degrees centigrade. SpaceX has chosen to use colder propellants because the lower temperature increases density. This means they can store more propellant on the same size fuel tank. Cooling the liquid oxygen to negative 207 degrees increases density by about 8% compared to liquid oxygen stored just below its boiling point at negative 183 degrees centigrade. However, this subcooling does come with some problems. The biggest problem being expansion. As the oxygen warms up, it doesn't just boil off as it does on other rockets. Instead, it expands. If the oxygen expands too much, it could rupture the tank and possibly cause a fire or explosion on the launch pad. I don't think I need to explain why this is a bad thing. So if the Falcon 9 countdown is delayed, it might cause a cancellation of the launch entirely, because the liquid oxygen will need to be drained from the tank before it expands too much. This is not a problem with liquid oxygen stored at its boiling point, where liquid oxygen just boils off as gaseous oxygen and can be easily vented. During the launch of SES-9, a boat wandered into the danger area offshore. The delay from the boat was long enough that the liquid oxygen had to be drained and the launch scrubbed for the day. The colder temperatures can also put more strain on the rocket. Ice on the outside of the rocket might accumulate faster. Ice buildup was one of the reasons Falcon Flight 21, which launched the Jason 3 satellite, failed its landing attempt. To rechill oxygen that has warmed up slightly is also more difficult. With most rockets, it's easy to pump in more liquid oxygen to make up for any that has boiled off. But with subcooled oxygen, the tank needs to be completely emptied and refilled. This emptying and refilling of the tank will also cause the tanks to expand and contract more, which could put unneeded strain on the rocket. So with all these problems that come with subcooled oxygen, why has SpaceX decided to use it instead of just increasing tank size? Well, they really can't increase tank size. The rocket can't be made any taller without risking making it too weak to survive flight, and the rocket can't be made wider because SpaceX transports their rockets on highways. Any wider and they would have to transport it by barge or rail, which would increase costs. Engineers at SpaceX have decided to use subcooled liquid oxygen in order to maximize the capabilities of the Falcon 9 while keeping prices as low as possible. It's design choices like this that have helped SpaceX develop one of the lowest cost heavy launch vehicles ever created.